Without thinking about it too much, try to guess who drew the following illustration. I'll give you a hint, it's the same artist who drew the famous Vitruvian Man. And if you guessed Leonardo da Vinci, then you are correct. But here's another one for you that's a bit more challenging. Try to guess where this illustration is taken from. Now, this might look as a simplistic, possibly unimportant illustration, but it's actually taken from Isaac Newton's Principia, one of the most important books in science history. Now, one could argue that Isaac Newton's work was more influential than Da Vinci's work on science. So why are most people more familiar with Da Vinci's illustrations? You see, Da Vinci knew that a very visually pleasing illustration can inspire the imagination of people who are not even familiar with your field of work. I call this approach the eye candy approach. Newton, on the other hand, mostly used visualizations when he was trying to explain complex scientific ideas to people who already have the background to understand them. Now, both approaches are very useful. It's just a question of what are you trying to achieve? If you want to cast a very wide net and inspire an audience that is not familiar with your field of work, then eye candy is the way to go. However, if you're trying to explain your innovation to a very deep level of understanding, then mind maps would help you do that. Now, both can be aesthetically pleasing, it's just a question of what you're trying to achieve. Da Vinci knew it, Newton knew it, and now you know it.